Hey everyone, I'm back with a new evolution clip. Before you start, make sure you subscribe for more interesting videos. Enjoy watching! Samsung's first S Pen was introduced with the Galaxy Note in 2011, which was called a phablet because it was a combination of the features of a phone and a tablet. The S Pen could detect 256 pressure points, its use being quite limited, functioning as a pen, pencil, brush, and highlighter. It could also be used for navigation, taking screenshots, handwriting, and touching the screen twice opened the S Memo application. The second S Pen was completely redesigned by Samsung, being longer, thinner, and more ergonomic, and was able to detect 1024 pressure points. Among the new features of the S Pen is the Air View feature that allows users to hover the pen over the top of an icon, email, or media to quickly glance at a preview without actually navigating away from their current screen. Another interesting feature was the Easy Clip that works by pressing and holding the S Pen button. With its help, one could quickly outline and crop content from virtually any screen and then pass on these crops to email, note-taking, and image processing apps. S Pen Galaxy Note 3 has brought improvements in terms of productivity features and handwriting. With Air Command, important functions could be instantly accessed just by ejecting the S Pen or pressing its button. Thus, with this function, it was easier to make calls, send emails or messages, and add oodles of notes to image captures. Also, another interesting feature is S Finder, which recognized handwriting and users could search for memos based on text. The S Pen Galaxy Note 4 also had major improvements in productivity tools, and the pressure sensitivity was doubled from 1024 to 2048 levels. With Smart Select, users could select, copy, or paste text from a website or document, the S Pen behaving like a mouse for the first time. Also, the Photo Note feature allowed the stylus wielders to clip individual parts of a photo and then copy, morph, and share them with a few swipes. A very interesting thing that the Galaxy Note 5 S Pen could do is the possibility to write directly on the phone screen even if it's turned off, the PDF writing function, and scrolling screen capture. At the same time, the S Pen could be ejected with a light push and no longer had to be removed manually as in previous versions. The Galaxy Note 7 S Pen was able to detect 4,096 pressure points and was water resistant, which means users could draw or write underwater or in the rain. It also had a new note-taking application, ScreenWrite, and Smart Select. But the most interesting feature was Animation Select, which allowed users to create a 15-second GIF by drawing a frame. The Air Command menu had three more new features, for example Magnify, which allowed users to zoom parts of the screen up to 300%, Glance shrunk down commonly used apps to a tiny square which could be checked at any time by hovering over it with a pen, and Google Translate embedded in the S Pen cursor. With the introduction of the Galaxy Note 8, Samsung has focused on improving the user communication experience to be as fun as possible. So Live Messages gave users the ability to use the S Pen to draw their own animated GIFs that can be shared with friends. Also, Translate could translate complex sentences and not just individual words like the version on Galaxy Note 7. Another interesting thing is Screen Off Memos, which allowed you to always fix notes on the screen as constant reminders. The Galaxy Pen 9 S Pen offered a wide range of note-taking and productivity-enhancing tools. It could be used remotely to photograph a group, for example, or to control slides and presentations using the Bluetooth LE function. Also, the S Pen charges in just 40 seconds when docked in the phone and will last for up to 200 clicks at a time or 30 minutes on standby. The S Pen on the Galaxy Note 10 was like a little magic wand. Users could control their phone remotely using simple gestures. For example, by pressing the S Pen button, users can switch rooms or shooting modes, zoom the picture, or can access other functions with customizable gestures. Another interesting and useful feature was the conversion of handwriting into text and the ability to export the file in different formats. The Galaxy Note 20's S Pen comes with many improvements and offers a realistic note-taking experience thanks to improved AI technology, a gyro sensor, and an improved accelerometer. Also, the latency has been reduced by almost 80% compared to the previous model, thus giving users a more realistic writing experience. In terms of gestures, Samsung has extended their controls to facilitate navigation on the phone, regardless of the application used. Thus, through this gesture, users can remove recent used applications. It redirects you back to the home screen. This gesture means an action back. It starts Smart Select and by moving the S-Right automatically activates the screen pin. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and share this video. See you in the next video.